Hello friends, this is Mig Jiménez from Spain, and this time I am here to show you one of my dreams and one of our best projects in ammo. Is the new T-54B in 1/72 scale. It's our new brand kit. You will find a very high quality inside. Of course, I was painting one. In fact, I am making two. This is my first one. The tile is just superior. I think that you will be very satisfied if you like the bright scale. I want to show you what is inside. I want to explain you how are the instructions and why is so special this model. Of course, the first thing that I must explain you is that this is my favorite tank from all times. Of course, the T-55 too, T-55, T-54, both are more or less similar, but I found that the T-54 is not available in the market and is one of the most special because can be made in Vietnam, in Yom Kippur, in Syria, in many other places. One important detail that I want to explain you before we can see what is inside the box is that 1 year ago I was in Vietnam, in Saigon, in Ho Chi Minh City, and I was able to meet with many modelers there. They are fantastic people. From here, I want to say hello to all of you, my friends. I really miss Vietnam. And when I was there, I was visiting different museums and presidential palace, and I was able to take photos of the T-55 and Type 59 Chinese version of the T-54. I was taking many photos, and in that time I thought I really want to make this model in plastic for my own company, you know, because I really love it. So that was the origin of this model just 1 year ago, and finally we have here. And I am so happy because we were able to have on time for the 44th anniversary of the reunification of Vietnam. Of course, we don't want to enter in politics or different opinions, because for us it's just history, it's modeling, this is part of the story. I am totally neutral. Some people maybe can find disappointed that here we put a sentence in Vietnamese, but this is just telling that is the 44th anniversary of reunification, because when that time, 30th of April, is coming in Vietnam, everybody in that country go to celebrate it, and they make a very nice party, and everything is beautiful. And the people go to visit the presidential palace where you can find this vehicle painted with exactly this number. So this is why this tank is so special, and also because according with the right information, this was the first tank who entered and destroyed the fences in the presidential palace. This is what most of the people say, but also I have read different stories from veterans. But doesn't matter, we want just to keep the official version of the story, and this is supposed to be the first tank who entered in the presidential palace. Of course, the model that you can find in the presidential palace right now is not the original one. They just put a replica, another model, because probably the original one was destroyed fighting in another battle, or maybe just abandoned or damaged, who knows, no? But what they used is a replica of another T-54, exactly similar, very similar to the original one. And this is the representation of that vehicle. Of course, it's not everything that you can find inside this box. We decided to put also decals for Egypt and Syria, the three countries who used this model of tank more often in war. Of course, many other countries used it. People from Russia, some friends are disappointed. Why not the Russian decals? Well, we decided just to put decals and version for the most important battles where this tank was participating. And the main one was, of course, Vietnam. So if you want, let's see what is inside the box. I will show you with the tile. I will show you also my little model. Another anecdote that I want to explain you. As you can see, I just made the one from the cover, that is one of my favorites, also the one from the t-shirt. But I made another model, that is the Quantru T-54. The Quantru is the name of a general from Vietnam, not from the previous century, but it's a very old general that was fighting in different wars, and they put the name of Quantru in the turret of this tank, just in case you have curiosity to know what is the meaning. In the back of the box, you can find some examples of the version. Of course, you will see much more inside, like the Quantru, Egyptian, Vietnam, but modern version before the renovations and upgrades that they made, with 3-tone camouflage, which is very interesting. Another Egyptian from Six-Day War, and one Syrian from the Yom Kippur too. Also, it's curious because I was able to find only one photo of one T-54 in the 1000 in the recent war of Syria. And we included the version, of course, have no decals, but we thought that could be interesting to show you that this tank still fighting nowadays in Syria. Stay with me and let's see what is inside the box. Thank you, friends. The box is the classic size for 1/72 kits. It's not too big, like you can see. Of course, we include versions for Vietnam, Egypt, and Syria, but the cover is dedicated to the Vietnam War, especially the Victory Day when they entered in the presidential palace. Like you can see, it's a beautiful illustration. And in the other side, you can find some examples of profiles. Inside the instruction, you will find much more, but here, if you are in the shop and you are checking the model, you can see the colors that you need, so you can buy at the same time in the shop. Okay. Inside, we can see the different components. We have the instructions, a big booklet with a lot of information, photos. Also, you can find the metallic tow cable, a little photo edge that is for the headlights cover, some part for the engine deck and the headlight in the commander's cupola, and the decals. For the decals, I must tell you that you will find many versions. You will see later inside the color profiles. Those are the ones that I used for my model. I used the ones for Quantru, the Vietnamese version. You can also see here that we include the flags, so you can put a flag in your model, and the different version for Egypt, the license plate, and more. There are three main plastic bags. One for the turret, with a very nice detail. Also, the Duska matching gun is beautiful. The other one is for the wheels. There are two sprues for the wheels and tracks, with a very nice detail, very crispy. And the tracks that are in different trams, but also in individual links. You have more links that you needed in case that you want to put extra links in the turret, or if you break or damage some of them when you are assembling the tracks, you have always spare the links. Finally, you have the another two sprues for the upper hull and more details like the boxes and other parts. And finally, you will find the hull in an individual plastic bag, and I will show you now the sprues separately, because I have here another ones ready to show you. This is for the hull. You can appreciate that the two frontal mud guards are incorporated. For my model, I just removed them with a cutter, so you can give to your model a more veteran look, if you want to say in that way. Here there are two parts. We took the inspiration from 135 scale kits. This is a good system to assemble the trucks. all that you must do is to glue here the two main wheels and start assembling the trucks around this kind of template. This helps you a lot to achieve the right shape of the trucks. It's very easy and the final look is very realistic, so it's a good addition for 1/72 scale. The grills are not in photo etch, but I think that is not necessary. I like more in plastic than grills because sometimes the photo etch in this scale is even too thick, no? But in plastic you will see that it's very, very detailed. The hull is very well detailed. If you know very well the T-55 or T-54, you will recognize all of those details, hatches, incorporated support for the wheels. It will help you to assemble your kit in a very fast way. This is the most interesting sprue in the kit because here you can see the size of the main boxes, the boxes that always appear in the size of the fenders, of the mudguards of the T-55, T-54. Those boxes usually are made in only one piece in most of the plastic kits in 1/72, but we decide to make the size of the boxes in different with different parts just to provide you an incredible good detail, so you will be shocked when you assemble it. And also it's very easy to assemble those parts. The fuel cells also very well detailed, and other components. Finally, here we have a couple of sprues with the wheels. Like I told you, you have more single links that you needed, and the trucks are super well detailed, almost like in 1/35 scale. Also the hooks and other details are very well done. We feel very proud with our kit. Finally, the turret, like I told you, very nice details, especially for painting. The Duska is one of the most important parts in this vehicle. And also remember that you have different options for the frontal visor. You will see now in the instructions. This is the small booklet of the instructions. Here you have an introduction. I visited the T-54 in the Presidential Palace 1 year ago, and this is why I decided to put some photos. It's my special dedication to the Vietnamese modelers. But this report will help you to improve your model if you want. If you want to add, for example, more details like those pipes or another rivet or something, or also just to check our model and compare it with a real one, could be a good reference for that. I will explain you later, but this symbol was not used in the original one. Remember, this is the national flag, the national symbol, but was not used in the Presidential Palace when they entered. Some historic photos and other photos that I took when I was there, just for inspiration. And here is the first recommendation for assembling the kit. We are using the same icons, the same symbols that we are using in the solution box, just to standardize our system and will help you to understand what to do, optional parts, repeat the process, or use super glue, or recommendation for glue, of course. The display of the different components and the instruction, classic instruction, but very clear, simple, easy to follow, very instructional and modern. This is what I told you before, how to assemble the side boxes. This is the fuel, cells, the real drums. Very easy, as you can see. Many parts, but very easy. Here you can see the optional parts for the matching gun hole and also the visor that you can put the version with glass or without glass. The gun barrel. And finally, some tips for painting, for priming, for weathering, that this is a good innovation. You know that we are specialized more in weathering than any other thing. But I think that this can be useful for for all of you. I'll show how to apply the decals. Of course, this is a generic image, but it's the same process. And finally, here you can find the different alternatives that we offer you for our kit. We decide to include only versions that were in combat, like Yom Kippur or Vietnam or in Syria right now. And this is why we doesn't include version from Russia or other European countries. So we apologize, but we decide to put more decals for those conflicts than others. In case that you want to make Russian, for sure you will have at your home some decals to do it. But we thought it's more important to save the space for all of those versions. More Vietnamese versions, Yom Kippur from the Six Day Wars. Egyptian from the Six Day Wars. The Yom Kippur one is this one from Syria. This is the one that I made, the Quan Tru, that is the name of a general. And this is a version that I wanted to include, even if it having decals. It's a version that we found in Syria in 2016. Probably is the only photo, or the only one T-54B that we have seen in internet or researching. So this is something extraordinary and original. Another Egyptian version. And finally, some recommendation of different books that we have at AMMO about 1/72, the one from Sergei Golikov, that he's a master in that scale and he gives you a lot of tips, how to improve the models, how to paint them, and our previous 1/72 weathering special book that we made with different authors. Both of them are highly recommended for you in case that you want to start with that scale, the Braille scale. So that's all what is inside. I will show you also some image of the finished model, and I hope you like it, and I hope you can do a very nice version with it. Thank you. Well, guys, this is what is inside. I hope you like it. I think that the quality and the details are very, very, very nice. Also, the way of construction you will find very easy. I hope to see your model painted. Please post in Facebook, start with us, photos in Instagram, but please start with us because I really want to see what you can do with it. Finally, just a little story about this t-shirt and about this symbol. The tanks who entered in the presidential palace, they used only numbers in the turrets. They never uses this symbol. If you go to visit the museum, you will find that the models, the tanks in the displayed in the park, have the national flag, which is exactly this one. It's the yellow star with the red background. But this is the Viet Cong flag. During the war, some tanks used this one, and other tanks used only the national flag. But the tanks who entered in Saigon, they never used the symbol, just to avoid political problems and other secondary obstacles. Of course, Saigon area was surrounded by Viet Cong, was the flag of that area. This is why we decided to make the t-shirt with the Viet Cong symbol. And remember, many tanks used it also, as T-54, T-59, but exactly the ones who entered in the palace, they never used that symbol. So that's all. I hope you like it, and see you in the next video. Bye bye from Spain. Bye bye.